एज यू नो पाइथन लैंग्वेज इज केस सेंसिटिव। केस सेंसिटिव मीन्स द लोअर केस एस डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कैपिटल एक्स। फॉर एग्जाम्पल कंप्यूटर एंड कंप्यूटर आर टू डिफरेंट वर्ड्स बिकॉज कैपिटल सी इज अपर केस इन द एग्जाम्पल फर्स्ट एंड लोअर केस इन द सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल। इन पाइथन प्रिंट इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम प्रिंट। प्रिंट इज जस्ट अ वर्ड वेयर द स्मॉल प्रिंट इज अ कमांड इन पाइथन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू हैव रिटन प्रिंट इन ए स्मॉल लेटर देन यू हैव गिवन अ लेटर लाइक यू हैव रिटन हैलो यूजर इन सिंगल कोट देन यू हैव गिवन आंसर इज इक्वल टू 42 देन यू हैव टू प्रिंट द आंसर इज in single quote then plus string that is your 42 is your string the output will be hello user the answer is 42 you should put the argument inside parentheses we can also pass more than one argument to the print function in such case the arguments are separated by commas like print hello it's given in double quote your output will be hello You can also pass more than one argument to the print. Like your example is given here. You have written print hello in double quote. It shows like this hello. Next is print hello, then comma, then Python. These are two words in double quotes. And your output will be hello Python like this. Using input function. Python provides the input function to accept any input from the user. In Python, input takes only string values. We can use integers or float along with input to accept integer value and float values. For example, to enter name and age and display it, these are your program by using input name is equal to input where what's your name then print nice to meet you and your name age input your age and print so you are already plus age your next program is like this a is equal to input b is equal to input in a into first number in b into second number then c is equal to a plus b then print c The numbers are joined in output as they are treated as string by Python. To show the use of integer function, example number 3 that is int in then input then enter first number then int in parenthesis you have to give input then parenthesis start enter second number then you have to close the parenthesis two times then a plus b then print c in parenthesis. Like this, it's given here. Into first number, you have given 22. Into second number, 43. Your answer will be 65. But in example number 2, if you will give write like this, a is equal to input, then parenthesis, then your numbers will be add. Like you have given here 22, then 43. It will be add like 22, 43. Like this. But if you want to add this number, you have to do like example number 3. A is equal to int, then start parenthesis, input, then start parenthesis, then enter your first number in double quote, then close the parenthesis two times. Next is operators in Python. An operator in a programming language is a symbol that tells the compiler or interpreter to perform specific mathematical, relational, or logical operations and produce a final result. There are some arithmetic operators. These operators are used to perform arithmetical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and exponential. These are your symbols plus for addition, minus for subtraction, multiply for multiplication, this is your division symbol, this is your modulus. Next is relational operators. These operators are used to comparison, they return either true or false based on the comparison result. The operators equal equal should not be confused with equal. The relational operators are follows like this. Equal equal shows check if the value of two operators are equal or not. If yes, then condition becomes true. Like this, not equal, this is your not equal. Third is greater than, fourth is less than, next is greater than is equal to, next is less than is equal to. And next is logical operators. These operators take boolean values as input and return boolean values. Like and n ampersand means logical and returns true if both x and y are true, else return false. Next is parallels. Logical are parallels. X parallels y returns false if neither x or y is true, else returns true. Next is exclamation mark. It's logical not. Nary operators returns true if x is false, else return false. Now chapter is completed.